What's up, guys? Tyler Horvath here. Welcome to another episode of The Daily Tea. Today, I'm going to talk to you about starting a successful AdWords campaign. So if you have been thinking about using Google AdWords to advertise for your site, or even if you have been using Google AdWords to advertise and you're not seeing the results you want, I'm going to show you today how you can create a really successful AdWords campaign that converts like crazy. So there are a few things to look at when you're first creating your Google AdWords campaign. Now, the first thing and the most important part is the type of advertising network that you're going to be advertising on. So Google has two advertising networks. There is the display network, which is, if you've seen Google ads on websites, and that's the other side of Google AdSense. That's the Google display network. So pretty much on websites, YouTube videos, all that kind of stuff that's not the direct Google search, that will be the display network. Now, I've probably spent $1 million in Google AdWords, and I've seen very few conversions with the display network. A lot of it is just accidental clicks and, people who are clicking on stuff on accident or, not buying. We don't see many conversions with the display network. So number one is use the search network only. You will see a lot more conversions, and it's a lot more highly targeted than the display network. And that's for the simple reason that you are targeting people based on what they're searching in Google. So you can get super, super specific on what keyword you want your ad to show up for. So when you're creating your Google AdWords campaign, make sure that you try and just use the search network only. This will give you a lot higher conversion rate because you're not going to be wasting a lot of money on display ads that don't, convert as well. So the next thing that you want to do is when you are creating your ads and your keywords, you want to use exact match keywords. And this is the best way to start out with Google AdWords. A lot of people will just create an ad and then they'll throw, hundreds of keywords in there. They'll use all the ones that Google suggests and they'll just throw them all in there. Now, this is the worst thing that you can do, and you do not want to do this when you're creating your Google AdWords campaign. With Google AdWords, you want to start slow, and you want to start with, as few keywords as possible and slowly start building over time to find the keywords that have, the highest conversion rate. So make sure that you start out with exact match keywords, which would mean that you're putting a quote on them, and the person has to be searching that exact term for your site to show up. So let's say that you want to rank for, Kansas City chiropractors. So your exact match keyword you would put in would be with quotes and Kansas City chiropractors, and then you would put quotes around it. So that means if someone searched this exact term, Kansas City chiropractors, then you would show up. So why is this better than normal? Well, for a few reasons. One, it's because you are getting an exact keyword and it's super targeted, and you know that you're only going to be getting people who are searching for that exact keyword. So it's a lot targeted, it's a lot more likely that they're going to be looking for what you're selling. Now, another reason is because not as many people are using exact match keywords. Like I said before, most people, when they create an AdWords campaign, they'll just throw a million keywords in there and just let it go. And so when you use an exact match keyword, you are, you're bidding against a lot less people because not as many people use this. So your price is going to be lower as well. So start off with, one or two, maybe three exact match keywords, and let it go. And you'll see a lot better conversions because you are, you're targeting that exact keyword, and you won't get any of the other fluff out there. So the next thing that you want to do is, as I said before, it's important to know what's going on your website and how many people are converting from AdWords. So the next thing that you want to do is you want to install conversion tracking. you aren't tracking conversions from AdWords on your website, you are missing out on a lot, and you're not going to be able to optimize your AdWords campaign to the best that it can be. Knowing where your conversions are coming from which keywords, which locations, which type of user, all this information is vital to knowing and to optimizing your campaign. So make sure that you install the Google AdWords tracking code on your website so you can see, you know, who's buying from which keywords and all that kind of good stuff. So the next thing that's important is having a good landing page. A lot of people miss out on this part. They think, oh, I'm going to make this awesome AdWords campaign, but then they don't think about their landing page or their website. If you have, you know, a bad looking website, it doesn't matter how good your ads are, you're not going to convert because, you know, you don't look like a legitimate company, or, you know, your website is not mobile responsive and you have people coming from mobile and it's all messed up. So make sure that your landing page is really good and that, you know, it matches up with your ad. So if you are looking for Kansas City chiropractors, then you should have a landing page that, you know, is about Kansas City chiropractors, and it has a call to action on that page where the person can, you know, sign up or fill out a form, and you can track that with your conversion code to see, you know, which keywords are converting the best. So now is the fun part. You wait and optimize. So run your ads for, you know, a few days, weeks, whatever. Start getting some really good data about which keywords are working the best and, you know, which devices are working the best. And now you can start adding more keywords and testing more keywords and seeing which ones convert, which ones don't. The ones that don't, take them out. The ones that are converting good, you can either, you know, increase the bid if you are, you know, seeing a good return on that, or decrease it, or, you know, optimize those for that. So now it's just a big circle of optimization. You're just going to keep going back in every day and checking to see you know, how your conversions are, lowering and raising bids depending on, you know, which keywords are working the best. So another tip that I'm going to give you, once you start adding more keywords, you can also use the negative keywords tab. Now, negative keywords are words that you don't want your ad to show up for. So, you know, you can go in and you can add keywords like, you know, free or information, stuff like that, where you know people will be searching for, you know, stuff that they're not actually going to be buying. So if someone's looking for free stuff or a giveaway, that kind of thing, you can add those keywords as negative keywords, and if that is in the term, then you won't show up. Now, it's important to remember that if you're using exact match keywords, you won't have any negative keywords because you only are going to be showing for, you know, this exact match. But if you start adding non-exact match keywords, then it's important that you put negative keywords in there so you don't, you know, show up for those terms that people aren't going to be buying for. So this is how you can set up and run a successful AdWords campaign. If you go by these six steps, you'll see huge increases in both your leads, and you're going to see big reductions in the prices that you're spending per conversion. So I hope this video helped you out a lot. If you have any questions, please comment down below. Be sure to follow me on YouTube. I'm always posting great content like this on how to start and grow businesses online. So thank you and have a great day.